Hi, my name is Judy L. Moore, and I'm a freelance editor with Black Wolf Editorial Services. Over the course of a variety of different videos, I've been showing you how to use Scrivener to your full advantage as a writer. Today, we're going to show you how to create your own template so you don't have to use the standard ones that come with Scrivener. So let's get started. We're going to go File, New Project. And we're going to actually create this template from scratch. There's been a couple of people who have asked me about how you can build things like your own front matters into new projects or existing projects. And I'm going to show you that at the same time. So we're going to come to blank, and we're going to create this template. I am going to put this straight onto my desktop. Normally I would put projects into a Dropbox. Literature and Latte recommend against using Google Drive. There has been reported cases where people have lost their entire manuscripts, so be warned. Yes, the same thing could potentially happen with Dropbox, but Dropbox is significantly more stable with Scrivener projects. So we're going to create. And I'm going to just minimize the project that we've been using, our Jules Verne project, for these videos. Increase the size of this window so we can see what we're doing. Just as a reminder, I do have a 24-inch screen, so I'm not going to maximize the window or it will clip the video. The other thing as well that you need to remember is I do have a Windows system. Majority of the operations that I'm going to be showing you today are the same between Mac and Windows. There are some minor differences, and I will highlight them when we get to them. This is our basic structure. We will have obviously our trash folder and, of course, our research folder. Our research folder will get all of the beloved information that we need to help build our manuscripts, all the various different pages that we get from the websites, and, of course, our various different research notes. Now, this draft folder, do not delete it. Do not change it. You can change its name, but that's about it. This draft folder is the one where all of our manuscripts are going to go. Every single chapter, every single scene. And if we do not have this folder, when it comes to doing the compile, we won't see our manuscript. As I said before, we're going to create a new template, but we're going to do one for, say, a series. So I'm going to show you how you can put more than one book into a Scrivener project at the same time. So if I right-hand click and I go Add, and I'm going to add a new folder. I'm going to call this Book 1. Now, there are multiple ways of doing this. You don't have to add the folder doing right-hand click. You can also come up to this green button with the plus and click the down arrow next to it, and New Folder, Book 2. Or we can also add a new folder by going Project, New Folder, Book 3. We are also going to move this untitled file, and we're going to put that temporarily into Book 1. Now, if I expand out Book 1, we're going to change this to our first chapter. So I'm going to right-hand click, Convert to Folder. I'm also going to rename it, and we're going to call it Chapter 1. Normally, when I'm writing new chapters, I will actually give the chapter name something a bit more meaningful, but because we are creating a template, Chapter 1 is the most appropriate. We can also add subscenes. So if I right-hand click and I go New Text, and we're going to call this a subscene. One of the other things we are going to do now, while we're thinking about it, we're going to turn on our inspector window, and we are going to change the label. We want this label to be labeled as a chapter. And we're going to come down, and we're going to change this one to a scene. Now, if you take a look, default, I've only got concept and chapter, so we need to add a label. We're going to go Edit, and we're going to click on this button here, and we're going to call it a scene. Now, if you're creating templates straight from the novel template that comes standard with Scrivener, all of these sort of things will exist already. Now, I don't know about you, I don't like pink. So I'm going to change the color of this. I double click on the color, and I'm going to make it green. I just don't like pink. So we'll go OK. We're going to change the label to a scene. And we're going to change the status of both of them to being first draft as well. Now what's happened with this, if I can bring this up to book one, looking at the cork board, that's this button here, we can see we've got a first draft, chapter one, a bring down. First, we've got a subscene that is in there, first draft. Now, I want to actually not just look at the cork board, I want to actually see what I've got in terms of the text within this chapter. So we're going to come to this button here. This section that's above the top dotted line is actually the text that's going to be in that folder. So this is my chapter. It's marked as a folder. It's marked as a folder, so the chapter numbering within Scrivener works properly. Now, the section that's in between these two dotted lines is actually our subscene. All right, and we can toggle between the full chapter mode or just the individual file by clicking on this. So we can now see just the individual file. And if I click on the subscene, we have, this is our subscene. Notice that this icon changed when we went to subscene, and it's because there are no children files. There's nothing underneath or part of the subscene in this. If I come back to chapter one, this icon has changed and it's become a multiple file structure. So again, I can turn that on. And that's only because we have multiple files within the one system and we've got subchildren files. Right, so we have everything that we want within this chapter. Now I'm going to make sure that I've got chapter one selected. I'm going to right-hand click and I'm going to duplicate. I'm going to change its name because Scrivener likes to put funky names on things. And we're going to drag that into book two. We're going to duplicate again, right-hand click. And we are literally going to drag that into book three. So we have the same structure between all three books. Now I need to add into this template system that I've got my front matters, or I'm not going to have any title pages. So I'm going to come back up to draft for the moment. Click on the cork board. We're going to right-hand click and we're going to add folder. We're going to call it Front Matters. Now, I need to move this out of draft. So I'm going to control left, and I'm going to do that once in this case. And if you're not sure whether you've moved it out of the draft folder, you want to make sure that it's at the same level. I'm going to change the icon. So I've right-hand click, change icon. And I'm just going to use this Front Matters one. Why not? Now here's one of the nice things about Scrivener. And this is why I didn't close my other project. You can copy files from one project to another by literally grabbing them and dragging across. I want all these templates we've got for our title pages. So I'm going to select the manuscript format, shift, select the rest, and literally drag them from one system into the other, right into the folder I want. And there they are. So if I expand, you'll remember this format from what we did before. Nice and simple. Now, one more folder we're going to create. Add a folder. We're going to call this templates. Again, the novel template within Scrivener does actually have this already built in. But to be honest, I don't like the templates that it puts in for the characters. So I'm going to create a new one. We're going to go new text. And we're going to create, say, bold, make it center. And then go left, because we can. Traits, I want to remember. And we can put eye color, hair color, or other traits. Now, we haven't quite turned this into a template folder yet, because if we go right-hand click up here, we don't have anything. There's no templates there. So we are going to make sure that we've got the templates folder selected, and then we're going to come up to project, and we're going to go set selection as templates folder. And that will change the icons that we have here, and it will put little T's next to them. We're also going to change this icon here because we can, and we're going to give it, I don't know, we'll give it an information icon. To prove that that's now worked, we'll come down to our research folder, and we will go add from new from templates, and look at that, we have characters. And we're going to call that one Joe. And we're going to create another folder under here and say story characters. Move Joe into that story characters list. And as a reminder, under research folder, you can add images as well. So if you happen to have an image that you're drawing inspiration from for your character, put it into here. Not a problem. Okay, so we now have created this template in a way that we can use. Now, most people would sit down and go, well, I'll just copy it every time. And that's a bit clunky, a bit messy. What we're actually going to do is we're going to come back up here, set it into a state that we're happy to use to start with, and we're going to go File, Save Template, Save as Template. And we're going to go Series Novel or Novel Series. We're going to turn it into under the Fiction category. And we're going to go OK. Just to show you what we've got, we go File, New Project, on Fiction. Take a look, we now have this novel series. So we can create our novel series. This is my custom template for a novel series. And we can go My Novels. Create. And so we've got exactly what we've just created. To alleviate the fears of those of you who are going, oh my God, she's put all three books into the same project. When she compiles, what are we going to do? Well, this is how it works. We go to compile hit button here, and we'll expand this out. Move it up so we can see what we're doing. Under this folder, this drop-down menu here, at the moment it says draft. If we go and select, drag the button down, we can select just book one. We don't want to include that book one title unless there's some other funky information that you want there. And we can also add our font matters down here. Add font matters, manuscript format. And it was nice and simple. Now, remember we did in a previous episode create a custom formatting to deal with the fact that we have a multi-tiered chapter system, so we have a second layered chaptering. We called that Scrivener Demo. If you remember, the reason why we did that originally was because we were putting in a prologue or a preface, but we can use exactly the same template structure for dealing with this issue too. It makes it nice and simple. And to swap between the books, it's even just as simple. Draft, we're now at book two. Not a problem. We're going to save and close that for a moment. Now, Say you want to share your template. What you can do is you go New, New Project, and you come down to these options. So I'm going to select my novel series, come down to Options, drag it up so we can actually see what we're doing. Options. We can either set this as our default template, so if we're doing this all the time, we can set it as our default. The standard one that is default for Scrivener is Novels. We can also import templates. So if somebody sends you a template that you want to import into the system, that's how you do it there. If you're downloading from the Literature and Latte site, the NaNoWriMo template that they put out every year, again, this is how you import it. You can also export your selected template, or for that matter, you can delete it. If you decide you really don't like it, you really don't want to use it, you can delete the bugger. One thing that you do need to keep in mind is that the templates that come for Windows and the templates available for Mac are different. If you want to share your beloved template that you have created on a Windows system and share it with a Mac user, you are going to have to give them the entire project that you created that template from, and then they are going to have to create the template themselves. The way they create the template is exactly the same as what I showed you. It was File, Save as Template. Exactly the same. But the template formats are different. So unfortunately, you can't share your templates from one operating system to another. But you can share the projects, and I will show you that in an upcoming video. Hope you found this useful, and I will see you next time.